Bonjour, mon petit chifle, Amber here, and today, when this video goes up, marks 1 year since the release of the 1975 second album, I Like Go You Sleep, For You're So Beautiful Yet So Unaware of It, buy it on iTunes. So in honor of that, Becca and I, yes, this is a collab, have decided to do two looks representing both eras and both of the 1975's albums. So it would be the self-titled and I Like When You Sleep. So if you'd like to see how I interpreted both album artworks, the album artwork for both albums onto my face, please keep watching. Okay, to start everything off, I'm using the Milani Eyeshadow Primer. So because this look is based on the black and white era, obviously I'm going to use the Naked Smokey palette. First, I'm using Combust, which is a nice light beige, to set the primer. And then I'm going to use Whiskey, which is one of my faves, to deepen up the crease. So next I'm taking this gray, Password, and running it slightly through the crease, but I'm focusing on the outer corners of my eye. And then of course I'm going to blend away any harsh edges. Just building the color and also really sharpening the wings of the shadow. Next, I'm picking up the tiniest bit of Black Market and putting it right over the last color, but mainly focusing closer to the actual lid. For the black and white era look, I was very influenced by the whole wine bottle on stage thing. So to get a winey effect, I am first using this Rimmel eyeshadow stick in the color Black Betrayal and putting that on the outer bit of my eyelid. Get a bit creative, and this is going to be a running theme throughout this video. I'm going to use my Milani lipstick in the shade Cabernet Blend to add a bit of red over that darkened purple. Now I'm just blending a bit more Black Market over top of that. For the white part of the black and white era, I'm using 13, still in Naked Smokey, and just putting that on my inner lid. I find this shade and a few others from this palette apply best when using your finger. Next, I'm just going to run a bit of this Marc Jacobs eyeliner in my waterline. Then to smoke out the lower lash line, I'm first going in with Whiskey and then with whatever the gray one was just on the outer corner. This era was very leather jackets, ripped jeans, and really winged out liner. So to get that really winged out liner, I'm using the Rimmel Smoke and Shine gel liner and a out of my eyeliner. I'm using more 13 as an inner corner highlight, and then to highlight my face, obviously I'm using my Anastasia Glow Kit, and obviously I'm using Crushed Pearl from said Glow Kit. Just dabbing a bit of Crushed Pearl over top of the highlight for added glow. And then, to set my face, I am using the L'Oreal Infallible Setting Spray, which was a gift from Becca, and I'm kind of loving it right now. And for mascara, yeah, I'm not gonna do the whole falsies thing because we know that never goes well. I'm first doing a coat of the Falsies Push Up Angel. Oh lord, Falsies Push Up Angel mascara, which I think is amazing for separating lashes. And then of course I'm going to do the rest with the Too Faced Better Than Sex. I'm going to use more of the Push Up Angel mascara on my bottom lashes, which is really what it was meant for. Now for lips. I'm starting off with the NYX lip pencil in Current just to define the shape of my lips, especially my Cupid's bow, which I think my natural one is non-existent. And then I'm using the Wet n Wild Mega Lash Liquid Cat Suit Lipstick in Goth Topic, which I think is a hilarious name. And also this color is amazing, this lipstick is amazing, I'm obsessed with it. And here's look one, or Smoke and Wine as I'm calling it, an ode to the black and white era, which was honestly the greatest era of the 1975 in existence, only in the second. Alrighty, let's do this. I am going in with the NYX Ultimate Brights palette. I've already primed my eyes and put the crease color down, so I'm picking up this bright pink fuchsia color. And for this look, I'm doing a halo eye, and I'm blowing out the outer corner as much as possible. Back into that palette, I'm picking up the more corally pink right next to it, which I've never used up until this look, and putting that over top of the pink, but more on the lid, not going above the crease. And as with the first color, I'm really taking my time to pack on that shadow and build up the color. So then, like I said, this is a running theme, I'm taking the ColourPop Ultra Metallic Lippy in Queen with a K, and popping that in the center of the shadow. I honestly think it looks so pretty on the eyes, and I don't understand how I'm just thinking to do this. Going back into the Naked Smokey palette, I am popping Dirty Sweet, which is another one of my favorite shades, over top of that to make it more of a rose gold color. I have a lot of inspiration from the actual artwork from the album and how blue was incorporated as well, so I'm taking this NYC Shimmer Eye Dust
in Tenacious Teal and running that under my lash line just for, I was about to say a pop, but this whole eye look is bright pink, so there's that. And because the pink era is polar opposite to the black and white era and you can never have too much glitter, I'm using the NYX Face and Body Glitter in teal and trying my hand at glitter tears. And I didn't have eye glitter primer, so I'm using eye drops and forming a sort of mini triangle under my eye. Then I'm going in with 13 and high as an inner corner highlight, and then back in the Gleam palette, highlight my face first with Hard Candy because pink. Then for added glow or a nice pop or any other excuse you can think of to use more highlighter, I am adding Crushed Pearl to the tops of my cheekbones. I tried it at the high points of my forehead because I have never done that before, and you know, just all over because why not? Then I'm spritzing again with the L'Oreal setting spray. Then I'm gonna, you know, breeze through mascara because I don't need to explain you doing the same thing over again. I'm starting with the Rimmel London lip liner, which you know is my fave, and Coffee Bean. I'm trying to go for a more muted lip. And then over that with the CoverGirl lipstick in Romance Mauve. And then I thought I'd try and do something different. I never wear lip gloss anymore, I don't know why, so I thought I'd top this whole lip look off with this Milani High Shine lip gloss that has a lot of glitter in it, because that's what we're going for. Okay, but I'm really stoked on how this look turned out. It reminds me of the lights from the live show. Hashtag aesthetic. So, here are my two looks inspired by the 1975 self-titled album, and I Like It When You Sleep For, You're So Beautiful Yet So Unaware of It. I hope you liked it. Like I said, this is a collab, so please make sure that you go over to Becca's channel. I will leave a card here and the links down below. Watch her video. Also subscribe while you're there. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like me, feel free to subscribe. All my places are down there so we can be buds, and I will see you very soon. Bye!